We are going to see how to delete a node from the doubly linked list. That there are three cases which we have to consider: whether if the node is a first node, or whether it is a last node, or the node will be in between. So let us consider if it is only one node, and then if it is going to be a first node. Let us consider this program. So first, we have the name of the function is deletion begin, if it is going to be the first in the beginning. So in that case, we will check again whether it is the only one node. So first we check whether it is empty. If there is any node only, you can delete. So what you are going to do is, first we check whether it is empty. The is empty is a function which will check whether the head is equal to null or not. If head is equal to null, means there is no node in the doubly linked list. So in that case, it will return a 1. So here it will check whether the list is having some data, some node or not. So if it is returning 1, 0, then only we will go here. So what we do is, here head is equal to, next step what we are doing is, we are checking whether head is equal to tail or not. What do you mean by head is equal to null? In doubly linked list, we are making the head to point to the first node, tail to point to the last node. But when you are inserting only one first node, only one node in that, then which means both head and tail will be pointing to the same node. After you keep adding node, the tail pointer will be made to point to the next till so that it will always be the last node. This is the logic. So here, if head is equal to tail, that means this is the only one node currently in the linked list. Which means you after removal, again the list becomes empty. So how to remove this only one node? That is what we are going to see here. Structure node, we are again creating, we are declaring a temporary pointer called CUR, which is of type node. Then we made this current to point to this head, which is nothing but our memory location 500. So CUR will be pointing 500 memory location, head is also pointing the 500 location, tail is also made to point to the location 500. This is the memory location where this node is present. Now head is equal to null. Then after this current is made to head, then we make head and tail to be null. Now these two are no more pointing to this. They have become, the location become null. They are not pointing no more to memory location 500. Then why we are pointing current to this, because after making the head and tail, after removing the head and tail to point to this memory location, we have to remove the memory location occupied by this node. So for that, first we assign that, then we make this to be null, then we delete this node by using the statement delete current. Now return. Suppose this is only one node, in case of only one node, then if it is going to be the first node, how it is going to act? Then we have to delete this node. So how you can, simple, you can make the head to point to the head next, so that the head is no more pointing. When the head is no more pointing the first node, whatever the head is pointing, that will become the first node. So this will become this no more accessible, but we have to remove the space occupied by this. So for that, first what we do is, we assign this node to some temporary pointer. That is what we are doing. Current equal to head. So now it is made to point to this, and then head is made to point to this head next, which is nothing but here. Yes, we are making that to point to this node. That is head next means, which is nothing but this. So then after making the head to point to this, the previous location of this has to be made null. So now head is pointing this. So head previous is made to null by this statement. So here we remove this, and then yes, now this is not at all pointing to this previous node. Now this is the starting node. Now we can delete by using the statement delete this CUR, which is the node which is pointed by this pointer CUR.